Hello everybody, I am Pravesh Agi. Welcome to my channel. I am a Chartered Accountant currently working as a visiting faculty with the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about security analysis. Now this is your CA final course, paper 2, Strategic Financial Management, and I am CA Pravesh Agi, professor for this lecture. So let's understand the definition of technical analysis. Technical analysis is the art and science of putting the stock information on a chart in form of various kinds of bars, and then we detect the different patterns and indicators to assess the market direction. To put in a very simple language, we try to put the share prices information on chart. So what we do is that we plot the share price movement over a period of time with the help of various kinds of bars. We learn about these bars later on when we understand how to make charts. And then we try to detect the market direction through the help of the chart patterns and some of the indicators which we'll be learning. And we'll understand those indicators and chart patterns as we complete our knowledge about technical analysis. It's a method through which we evaluate the securities by analyzing the statistics generated by the market activity, such as the past prices and volume. Here we collect all the information with regard to the share prices and the volume, that means how many shares have been bought and sold in the stock exchange. So we collect this information and then we try to evaluate to understand the direction of the stock or whether they will trend or remain range bound. So in technical analysis, we are not bothered about the actual business behind the stock. So we are not worried about the fundamentals of the stock, that is how much profit it is making and how much profit it will make in future. So technical analysis studies the supply and demand in a market in an attempt to determine what direction or trend will continue in the future. So with the help of supply and demand with regard to the share price movement, we try to attempt to determine what direction, that means in which direction the stock price will move, whether they will trend or they will be in a range bound situation in the future. So the assumptions behind the technical analysis are that the market price of the stock is based on its supply and demand. If the demand outstrips the supply, the share prices will go up. And other way, if the supply outstrips the demand, the prices are going to fall. So one of the assumptions of the technical analysis is that the share prices always moves in trend. That means if the share prices are going up, they will continue to go up for some period of time. Or if the share prices are falling, then they will continue to fall for a certain period of time. Now, the technical analysis relies on charts analysis rather than the information in the financial statements, that is the balance sheet, profit loss account, cash flow. So they don't care about all the fundamentals of the company, but the more reliance is on the chart analysis. So now let us understand the principles of technical analysis. Now, the technical analysis is based on some fundamental assumptions, the way or the fashion in which the market operates. The first principle being that the price discounts everything. Second one, prices usually move in trends. And finally, the third one, that history repeats itself over the time. So let's understand now the first principle, which says that the price discounts everything. The chartists believe that the price of the market reflects all the possible causes, such as fundamental, political, psychological. So therefore, the study of price and volume is all that is required to understand the market direction. So the technical analysis believe that it is the movement of the prices which reflect all possible causes, be it a good news with regard to the performance of the company in terms of its profitability or any other good news with regard to the company. So all will be captured in the prices of the company and it will be discounted by the share prices. Or it is only the study of price and volume that is required to understand the overall direction of the market. Now the second principle is that the prices usually always move in trends. Now, as per the technical analysis, the price movements are believed to follow trends. The whole purpose of charting the prices of a market is to identify the trend in early stages of its formation. So basically, when we make a chart out of the price movements, we try to identify which way the stocks are headed and we try to capture the trend in a very early stages of its formation so that we can trade accordingly. If we feel the market is going to go up, we'll take a long position. And if we think the share prices are going to go down, then we take a short position. So this means that after the trend has been established, the future price movements is more likely to be in the same direction as the trend. So if we are able to understand which way the stock prices or which way the market is going to go, whether up and down, then we can always take positions accordingly. If the prices movement suggests or the stock prices are going to go up, then we take a long position. Or if the price movement suggests that they are going to fall, then we take a short position. So we try to identify the trend in a very early stages of its formation. And once the trend is identified, we know that it will continue for some more time, in a short period of time, so that we can take a position accordingly. Now, the third principle of the technical analysis is that the history repeats itself over time. So a technical analysis uses the chart patterns to analyze the subsequent market movements to understand the trends. So chart patterns, for example, have been identified and characterized over the past 100 years to reflect a certain pictures. So these pictures appear on the price charts and reveal bullish or bearish psychology of the market. So as these patterns have worked well in the past, it is assumed to work well in the future as well. The future is just the repetition of the past. Hope you all enjoyed the lecture as much as I did presenting for you. Do add your comments, as it is very encouraging and motivating. Please do like and do subscribe. Thank you.